Well, this is James Kahn again, the bike. And we're coming to you from Chime and Reed. We're gonna run in and take a look at a show by Jack Pearson. We've got some aged plastic. It's got some rain stains on there. Some age. Sun bleach. Jack Pearson is a pretty well-known multimedia artist. And he works with sculpture, video, and photography. I think what he's most well known for are his wall pieces that he's constructed using scavenged elements from signs. This is abstract number 18. This is on metal, although I thought it was wood. Takes on kind of a figurative quality there. This is titled Abstract Number 11. White neon and metal. It's nice because we're just dealing with V's, L's, and O's. One of the interesting things about his latest show is that he's trying to use the more abstract elements of the letters so that you can't really read words or sentences or derive any of the linguistic meaning. Oh, I think this is the artist right here. Where's Jack Pearson? This piece is titled Flourish, and it's plastic. Well, it's very exuberant, kind of Baroque. And this piece is titled Purest Way Serene. This is really nice because although these were elements of signs and were parts of letters, it's really broken it up and made them functions as just forms and color, but this is nice with the grungy little light sockets in there. Sculpture. It's titled Abstract Number 10. And one of the great things about using this kind of scavenged or found materials is that you're able to get a surface and color that's impossible to get in the studio. You just can't simulate this kind of natural patina. Just a nice form altogether. This is titled The Shine of Luxury and Pride. Seen some of the recent Calm reports, you might have seen the Frank Stella show with Paul Kasman. And there's a certain relationship between the kinds of forms that they're using, industrial materials. Although I have to say that Jack has stayed flatter. It's nice the way they've activated the neon here. What a cute puppy. There's Robert Curcio. And this large blue piece is titled Abstraction Number 15. Shove our faces in here, see if we can get a picture of the whole thing. This is titled Her Ancient Solitary Reign. Again, we've got the great zippy plastic colors. We could also call this O. O, 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 O. I think it's also interesting that this not only references the letter O, but it also kind of recalls framing unit. Through slaughter to a throne. And although these are just fragments, as you look at this, the mind kind of requires some kind of linguistical interpretation. It almost looks like Hebrew lettering or something. This is probably the smallest piece in the show. It's titled Nice. So this is all happening within a maybe 20, 22 inch square. It's nice when you have the kind of weather-beaten, aged, rugged surfaces against a very pristine, black, shiny surface. It's nice. Now we'll sneak a peek in the back room. Some great Linda Bangless poured polyurethane pieces on the floor. Jack Pearson piece. Oh, and here's one of our favorite painters, Jonathan Lasker. Pearson's Abstract here at Kyman Reed.